Yeah, these sparrows aren't tame by any means. They still run away if a stranger approaches too close. I had that one zoomed in. It was 40 feet away. Now I just have to see where it flew. Well, let's back up a little. Oh yeah, there was one there. Where'd it go? Okay. And the little buggers. I don't see any of those goldfinches. I went somewhere. Okay, I'm gonna look out to the water, but I sort of have to fix this. I have to make this level. There we go. I should be putting out some smoke. She'll be leaving soon enough. Half an hour, maybe sooner. There's one boat. Have to level this off again. Well, that boat was out beyond the island for 3 days. Now it's coming in. It might be coming into port, I don't know. Oh, I guess only time will tell. Judging the size of the island and the size of the boat, that's a pretty sizable boat. Oops, that's my fault. I ran into the... My hand hit the... stabilizer. There's... It locked in now. That's a very large boat. It doesn't look like a container ship, that is for sure. Well, that tanker's quite a distance away from it, 600 feet, 600 to 800 feet away from this boat right there. So that one in the picture now is about 1 mile away. This one here is at the half mile mark. That one, wait, let me, this one at the left of the picture is almost a half mile, and this one here is around 1300 to 1500 feet. In distance from where I'm standing on the shore. And I see the pilot boat up behind it. There's only one tug moored at the tug station. So the other, there's five tugs somewhere. There are two of them should be coming from the Inner Harbor or from Courtenay Bay, if that big ship is going to be coming in. Now, in the old days, the harbor pilot would have to actually go onto the boat in order to get all the paperwork. A shipping agent still goes onto the boat and inspects it. But for all the other information, they can do it through computer now. Transmission of information via internet. The world sure changed since the days of the great navigator, since the days of Cartier and Champlain. Yeah, sounding lines were replaced by sonars. You can talk to somebody on the other side of the world at the push of a button now. Everything changed. Yes, this boat at the center here, in a way, is much bigger than the tankers. I just do not understand what it would carry for a load. It looks suitable for potash, to carry potash, but the potash industry died. So I don't know. There's the oil or gas tanker right there. Yeah, the footpaths on this field are white with frost, but the tops of the plants, standing plants, are still green. That's frost. And everything above it is still lush. The sun is warming it up. And I see I have to adjust this. Oh, that's adjusted as far as it's going to go. It's the ground that I'm on. That might be a gas tanker because it keeps pointing its way right to Cannaport. That's a tug out there. Another tug, another tanker. And that's Cannaport. Aha! The Bay Ferries is finally moving. I almost missed it. Yeah. Powerful engines. Well, yeah, she churned up the water, the seagulls. There's not many out there, but the ones that are there, they're all excited. There's fish churned up in that prop wash. Yeah. All those specks. Yeah, there's 40 or 50 seagulls. All excited over there, but that is not the big flock. I adjust this leg here. No, that's still not. Well, it's better than it was. I hope Papa Herschel and the crew have a good day. This other boat here definitely is going toward Cannaport. It has to be one of the, it's a gas boat. Yeah, definitely no smoking on that boat. All right. I'm off to the blind, see if there's any seal activity. I will see you online.